If you does not renounce all that who has cannot be my disciple. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke chapter 14, verse 25 to 33. At that time, great multitudes accompanied Jesus, and he turned and said to them, "If anyone comes to me and does not hate his own father and mother and wife and children and brothers and sisters, yes, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not bear his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. For which of you, desiring to build a tower, does not first sit down and count the cost, whether he has enough to complete it? Otherwise, when he has laid the foundation and is not able to finish, all who see him begin to mock him, saying, 'This man began to build and was not able to finish.' Or what king, going to encounter another king to war, will not sit down first and take counsel, whether he is able with 10,000 to meet him who comes against him with 20,000? And if not, while the other is yet a great way off, he sends an embassy and asks terms of peace. So therefore, whoever of you does not renounce all that has cannot be my disciple." The Gospel of the Lord.
You are not a young man.
Was in return for the last minister. We are preparing ourselves to the dance of this task. The dance you are moving on it, we are dance. The dance you are moving on it, on foot. The dance you are moving on it, with your friends, with your families. We are expecting to go down on the dance. But even so, it's not like you came to go to class, to go to mind, it be the consciousness of God's love and peace. Christian is taught to acknowledge that our destiny is to be with the Lord. Our destiny is in heaven. If our destiny is in heaven, let us be good with our brothers and sisters. The letter of heaven is a subject of Paul's letter. It is a letter talking about beautiful example of love in practice. It is talking about the forgiveness of God the Father. It is talking about detachment from material goods. And this is what I want to tell us and say something about it. He is in prison. Fellow, listen. He has made a Christian for runaway slave of Onesimus. The letter is a message. He needs him to take back Philemon to his master, to take care of him. He said in Christ, there is no greater slave nor free. Since in God's eyes, all are one in the people's sight. We are all one before God, and we need to respect ourselves. Philemon was a prominent Christian in all the city. And an honor of slave and Christian. This slave had run away from his honor and his home, and had come in contact with Paul and had become a Christian. The letter of Pharaoh is a beautiful example of love in practice, of forgiveness, detachment from the material goods. My brothers and sisters, the love was experienced of the Lord. And be the name the apostle of love. You need to be apostle of love. You need to be apostle of peace. This is because these sermons began and ended in love. We contract all things. The resurrection is the greatest miracle. We, in mysterious ways, express our power over these greatness. It was love that led Christ to the cross. God raised him from the dead in love for humanity, that we, in turn, may believe in him and be served of our forgiveness. My brothers and sisters in Christ, detachment and kindness, we see ourselves in the infinite desires. We see ourselves in the service of money and material things. Remember the word of Jesus. No servant can serve two masters. For either he will hate the one and love the other. Or he or she will be devoted to the one and despise the other. My brothers and sisters in Christ, possess your possessions. I know we have many possessions. There are possessions of men and possessions of women. But never allow your possessions to possess you. South Sudan is the peace of heaven and heaven with the love of the Lord of the source. But we ended up by killing ourselves. We lost the harmony to be together as children of God. Only focusing on the abolition. Focusing on nepotism, focusing on corruption, while other people are suffering without food in this country. Corruption is killing our living. Corruption is killing our enter the blood of South Sudanese. We need to come out from it. It is a great thing. This thing is moving with prayer and kneeling before our patient.
and say we are sinners, so that we move out of this academic corruption in this country. My brothers and sisters in Christ, you are not permitted by God the Creator to allow material things to harm you. You are obliged by God to subdue and conquer the material things, but you are not free to allow the material things to conquer your life. So you must be careful about it. So you are free to possess possessions, but you are not free to allow possessions to possess you and invest the rest of the people in this country. In our country, homes, offices, and even buildings, there are so many men and women who are already prisoners of possessions. Many of us are prisoners of possessions. You know yourself better. Remove yourself from this so that you receive blessings from God. In appearance, they are free, but in their hearts, in reality, they are in prison. Something has struck and taken the key, especially the devil, and strength of their lives away. It touched them with the material things. Make us all respect one another. Our gospel is so beautiful. The gospel of Luke, chapter 14, verse 25 to 33. My brothers and sisters, whoever of you does not allow the shoulder of the rest cannot be my disciple. Jesus is here. Everybody, where he is. The brothers to the gospel, Jesus has laid down three conditions for the disciples. Earlier, he had spoken of this passage to three will be disciples. Who will be disciples? This time, he respects the urgency and seriousness of the gospel. First, the disciple was ready to put family demands in second place. Luke has already told how Jesus this time is taking the temple to be in his father's palace rather than the back home with his family. He said to his mother, "I am in my father's house." We need to have this also. You go to your father's house so that you receive what you expect. But he did not answer the commandment of love for parents. As you made clear to the little man. The second is, the disciple must be open to a life of self-denial, symbolized by the bearing of the cross. Simon did this when he carried the cross behind Jesus on the way to Calvary. My brothers and sisters, you have many crosses. If I ask one of you, you have crosses for me. Crosses, family crosses is the body. Individual crosses is the body. Community crosses is the body. All this is like saying, carry them to Jesus. Carry them to our Savior, and He will solve them with you. The disciple must be ready to give up all possessions. Give possessions to the poor. Share your possessions to the needy, with those who are suffering, with those in prison, and you receive more. Matthew chapter 7:7, ask, and you will hear. Knock, and you find. Search, and all these are important for you. Those who are possessing possessions, if you possess the possessions for the whole of your life, will take you to the cemetery. There are people who have to enjoy the possessions. Share the possessions with your brothers and sisters so that the blessings will end in the family. Jesus himself did this and so he addressed some of the very necessary situations. My brothers and sisters in Christ, in this life, we don't have some injuries, loss, and inconveniences come our way. But let us only decide, because Christ is in our way, is in our side. We meet problems, get away, and difficulties in this way. He has us, but they are our bosses. We have to bear them and come upon our master, Jesus Christ. Whoever does not bear his own cross and come after me cannot be by his side. With Christ and confidence, Jesus calls us up to face whatever is facing. Now we are open, my brothers and sisters. The hardship, the tiredness of life are the forces of God that make us strong and tough Christians here. They are designed to bring us to this point, to be strong Christians. Bearing a cross, therefore, is nothing but accepting the joy of suffering and inconveniences that come to you in your uncomfortable situation. My brothers and sisters, whoever you cannot change, you are duty to accept the love that's coming from the hand of God. I encourage you, as your pastor, don't be sad about it. Don't be sad about the process of the very day. Your sufferings and troubles are not justice. So when the face of it, they say it is a curse. No, they are not curses. They are blessings. They are blessings from God. They are part of life. Everyone has his own value to bear. Go through my life, I will do and this way. Pain frees us from God's soil, deceitful prosperity, and worldly blessings. Suffering is sent from our fear and conviction. God wishes this to convince us. The soul rests in me as the abundant room and opportunities to grow in peace and grace. They are living messages from the living God. My brothers and sisters in Christ, don't worry about completely or demonstrate any inconveniences. They are instruments of peace. They are instruments of unity. God is only true good and at every time of the kingdom of God in heaven. They are means to receive responsibility. Look good at his face. Smile at your difficulties. Fear your God's throne and follow Christ. Look unto Jesus, who makes the man easy and the old life. To continue to pray. Our brothers and sisters who have gone away with us, especially Reverend Professor Dr. Cesar Ndugu Jambi, may so rest in peace.